Hello everyone. In this video, we'll try to understand the importance of a variable using a technique called p-value. Okay, so first we'll try to understand what is a future selection. We know what is a future. It's nothing but a column or a variable in a given data, right? So when you got to talk about the future selection, right? It's a way of selecting a required columns or way to reduce the number of columns. So which of the columns are not required to build a model, right? So it is one of the core concepts in machine learning which impacts the performance of our model. So if I want to get the best accuracy of my model, obviously I need to think about the columns which are really required to build a model. Because if I train my model with the irrelevant columns or future, right, the model performance will impact badly. So there is a famous saying called garbage in, garbage out, right? So if I give a bad variable or a bad column to my model, obviously my result would be bad, right? So one of the important assumptions, right, in the linear models is that the correlation between the independent and dependent variable should be strong, right? If the independent is not variable is not correlated with the dependent variable, then we can remove that variable, right, which we already understood in our previous videos. Okay, so one of the assumptions we just discussed is that dependent and independent variable should be strongly correlated. What happens if it is not strongly correlated? I cannot use my linear models, right? So in that case, we need to think about the non-linear models, which we are going to discuss in our upcoming videos. So we'll try to understand the benefits of a future selection, right? It helps the machine learning algorithm to train faster. Obviously, right? Let's say training an machine learning algorithm with 100 columns and training a machine learning algorithm with 50 or 60 columns, it makes a lot of difference in terms of performance, right? Obviously, right? So we just discussed, right? So if we add irrelevant columns to a model, obviously the accuracy will get reduced, right? And it reduces the overfitting of the model. So as we discussed in today's session, we'll try to understand the significant or importance of a future using a p-value, right? So let's get started. So we are using the same Boston data set. So we already performed all these steps. Now let's straight away, find the p-value. So in this model, right? Sorry, in this video, right? We are using stats model. You remember, right? So in our previous videos, we use sklearn to train a linear regression model, right? So in this video, we'll use stats model. That is one of the famous package in Python, right? So you'll understand why we are using it. Let me import the package. API as SM. Spell wrong. STATSMODELS. Yeah. So one of the strange thing which I observed in stats model, right? So we don't have a constant. So let's say we know the formula, right? Y equal to mx plus c. So when you go for sklearn, it will calculate the m and c, obviously. But when you go for stats model, it will calculate only m. It won't calculate the c, which is our constant. So we have to tell the stats model, hey, please include the constant. I don't know the reason why they removed it, but this is how it works, right? So let's our x train. I'm just showing you how to add the coefficients, right? So sm dot add, sorry, constant nt. Come on, x underscore train. It's a spelling mistake. Oh, sorry. Yeah, let me. Yes. Now we have a constant, right? Let me see what it has. Yes, we added a constant, right? So now let's try to fit our model, right? sm.ols, we know my y variable and my x train underscore sm. Now I'm fitting it. yes, my leaderboard model is fitted. Now, the best part about the stats model is you can see the summary where we can't see it in SQL. Did you see this? This feature is not available in SQL, right? So see, in one go, you find R square, you find adjusted R square, you find F statistics, whatnot. So whichever is required, you know, to understand the performance of a regression model, we have everything here, right? So the one which I'm talking about at the initial, right, initial of this video is about the p-value, right? So now this p-value, right? So as per the stats, right? So any value, if you see the p-value, right? If it is greater than 0.05, any value, p-value here, if you're seeing here, is greater than 0.05, I can simply say that variable is not significant. I mean, I need not to consider that variable for building a model. That is, this is one of the way where you can find the importance of a variable or future. So yeah, if you see index, right, it says 0.790, which is obviously greater than 0.05. So I can say this index is not a significant variable. CHAS is not a significant variable. AH is not a significant variable. So this is the statistical technique to find if your variable has a significant to build a model or not, right? So that is the usage of the p-value, right? So the another one which I want to discuss is the F statistics, right? So F statistics and this probability F statistics will give you the overall significant of our model, right? So when you talk about p-value, right, it will give you the individual variable contribution, how important it is. But when you talk about this probability of F statistics, it will tell you how significant is your model, right? If overall prop F statistics is less than 0.05, then our model is significant. We'll see if it is less than 0.05. Oops, it is definitely not. I always bad at this exponential, but yes, so it is definitely greater than 0.05. So obviously it says this model is not insignificant, maybe because of the variables, insignificant variables which we just added, right? So hope you enjoyed this video. So we'll discuss even more topics on the feature selection, right? This p-value is one of the techniques. So we already discussed correlation and we discussed the p-value, p-value, right? So there are more, you know, ways to find the importance of a variable. So that we are going to discuss in our upcoming videos. So in the next video, we'll try to understand the multicollinearity and its importance on the p-value. Okay, stay tuned. Thank you. We'll meet soon.